Introduction to Data Science. And today's session is Real Direct Online Real Estate Firm. In this session, I would like to tell you about the machine learning in real estate, the trends and applications presented. Nowadays, we all know about machine learning is very much popular because when it will combine to the AI, so we can place those instructions into a chip, and that chip will be inserted into a robot, and that robot will behave work like a human being, right? So scientists are also working on the on some feelings and emotions like humans have to put it on the robot, but it is not exactly possible because it is just like a machine. So in the real estate, this also is a very important thing in the real estate market. So in the USA, currently a seller's market with demand outstripping supply and housing affordability going down steadily for 2018. The report is from the Gallup, May 2018. So this means that the buying and selling properties are being made possible with the help of machine learning, and other AI based applications are creeping their way to into maintenance, energy management and more. So in this article, we'll explore the applications of machine learning in real estate, right? So for the business leaders to find the real estate applications and machine learning insights that matter most of them. So we have broken this article into some subsections like why machine learning matters in real estate, the state of artificial intelligence in enterprise, three applications of machine learning in real estate. In this we have seen proxy applications, application area 1, 2 and 3 in this customer application, chatbots and so many things. And then the deciding yes or no on machine learning applications, lastly the concluding thoughts, avoiding hype and moving forward. But I would like to discuss these two points in this today's session. Now let's proceed. Why machine learning matters in real estate? This is a very important question. So the interviewers with the hundreds and thousands of machine learning researchers as per the AI industry, so this shows that they agree on very little in terms of big pictures, that is dynamic of machine learning. So there is no consensus on which industries will be transformed first, no consensus about AI risk in the coming 20 years, and no consensus on a definition of artificial intelligence. So this AI will change a lot of how business is done in the coming decades or two, as the internet did in the past two decades, right? So the goal of basically the article is to promote a realistic picture of enterprise artificial intelligence in general and in real estate in particular. So this enables decision makers to distinguish between the aspects of artificial intelligence that will have some value to a business and the 90% that will not. So the state of artificial intelligence in enterprise is that the it was exciting and novel in the 60s, then went through another period of enthusiasm in basically in industries and academia in 1980s. And in the 60s and 80s, artificial intelligence was not common leveraged in business applications, and the largest companies during these decades were not predicted on artificial intelligence to deliver their services or product. So because the only thing, intelligence is of course important, but machine learning with a combination of AI gives some better results, right? So this AI, the technology, hence this would not be able to reach their current prominence without machine learning. So in many ways, machine learning is still finding its way into most business applications. So the researcher shows that in general, about 1 in 3 artificial intelligence or machine learning companies have the requisite AI intellectual capabilities, meaning an executive with robust artificial intelligence experience from academia or a previous job. So only 1 in 3 will have some degree of tractions with a pilot program with documented business values. And this, even then, this 10% of AI companies that have the capability may not be profitable yet, because they are still trying to figure out how to produce consistent results and solve real business problems, right? So both AI and ML, that is machine learning technology, today requires a significant investment in resources, more than most business people expect. And of course, there is no guarantee that the end solution will work. Okay, because we are working on a platform of machine, right? So the third one is the applications of machine learning in real estate. This real estate is far behind other industries like healthcare, finance, transportation in terms of total artificial intelligence innovation and funding for machine learning companies. However, real estate professionals can look at proxy industries to see how they leverage AI to solve similar problems in the real estate, because you all have heard about the live robots and robot teachers, like robot servants. So they replace that those human in place of this machine, you can say. So of course, real estate is also an important part in this world, and of course people want that there is some kind of that thing which is useful for those purposes which took place the work of the persons, because it is sometimes a tiring job for the people to go here and there. So we people have choice that that the robot will take over that work. Okay, so there are two major AI applications categories to which the real estate industry can look for proxy industries in consumer facing and predictive technologies, right? So the proxy applications are the consumer apps, chatbots, and machine learning based interfaces. They for customer facing applications such as chatbots or matching people with properties, the e-commerce and consumers technology space are where it comes out first. So their applications in the real estate industries will only be able to adopt it once it has been developed in industries that are moving faster. The second is the predictive maintenance in manufacturing and heavy industries. So for predictive technologies such as the maintenance or upkeep of equipment, assets and properties, the manufacturing and heavy industries space are most likely to do it first. Efforts in developing the technologies and processes to optimize this function are more likely to give a return in these industries than in real estate. So you can say real estate executives looking into predictive analysis, okay, smart technologies and the Internet of Things, that is IoT applications, which is now very popular. Okay, so in general, you can say it can take their cue from technologies developed in these industries. Okay, so these two major categories of AI technologies and representatives of that type of innovations, you can say, these are the potential values for real estate in the future. So here are basically three possibilities to improve the efficiency. Okay, so what are those efficiencies? We will discuss in our next session. Okay, so thank you so much. And this session powered by Digital Version 2.0, Jayoti Vidyapeeth Women's University, Jaipur. Hope you are satisfied with my digital session. If you have any query, please mention in comment box. I will resolve it. Thank you.